Welcome to the Matriarchal Facilitator. I pray everyone is doing well out there this evening. I am. I have a message from the Lord, and that message is look out for the elderly. Let's pray. Father, I just give you all the praise, all the honor, all the glory, Lord God. Lord, you are worthy, Lord God. Thank you for your son, Jesus, Lord God, who died upon the cross for our sins, O Lord. Lord, I ask, Lord God, that you just watch over families, Lord God, that you heal broken hearts, Lord God. Lord God, that you will set free those who are in prison, Lord God, in Jesus' name. Father God, I yield and submit myself unto you. Use me, O Lord. Have your way. Lord God, I decrease and I allow you to increase. And it's in your son Jesus' name I do pray. Amen. This is the parable of the widow and the judge. So, I was in my kitchen cooking one day when I received a message in my spirit about a member of my church. And I was like, okay, Lord. Anyway, I ended up calling her because the Lord placed her on my heart. But I was actually thinking about her daughter earlier that day and not realizing that actually it was the anniversary of the daughter. Matter of fact, that day, I didn't even realize that until I called her, how the Lord unctioned me to call her. And so I called her and she was like, hi, how are you? And I said, I'm fine. And we talked for like 30 something minutes. And she was like, you know, I always ask your mom how y'all are doing. And I told her, thank you, you know, for that and stuff. And she's like, what made you call me today? And I said, well, I was thinking about your daughter earlier, and then I was listening to a song, you know, and so your name dropped in my spirit, and the Lord just told me to call you. And so I'm just being obedient, you know, calling you to check on you, to see how you're doing. She's like, oh my gosh. She's like, thank you for listening, you know, and being obedient and calling me to my... This is, I'm going to repeat what she said, Lord, she's so sweet. She said, this is better than money, girl. I said, okay, bless you. But you know, God is so good, guys. He's so good. And I'm just telling this story because God is so faithful. And when he drops a name into our spirit, he really wants us to check on people, guys, to do that. We don't know what someone is going through, what they're dealing with. So we need to be checking on individuals, drop-ins, check-ins, whatever you want to call it. Call them up. See what's going on. Check on them, whatever it is. So I have some scripture references that I want to read. We have Luke 18, 1 through 8. He told them a parable on the need for them to pray always and not become discouraged. There was a judge in a certain town who didn't fear God or respect man. And a widow in that town kept coming to him saying, give me justice against my adversary. For a while, he was unwilling, but later he said to himself, even though I don't fear God or respect man, yet because this widow keeps pressuring me, I will give her justice so she doesn't wear me out by her persistent coming. Then the Lord said, listen to what the unjust judge says. Will not God grant justice to his elect who cry out to him day and night? Will he delay to help them? I tell you that he will swiftly grant them justice. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man comes, will he find that faith on earth? We have Isaiah 1:17. Learn to do good, seek justice, correct oppression, bring justice to the fatherless, plead the widow's cause. And we have Ruth 4:14. Then the women said to Naomi, blessed be the Lord who has not left you this day without a redeemer, and may his name be renowned in Israel. So when the Lord dropped her name in my spirit, I immediately contacted my mom to get her number because I didn't have her number. Her and my mom are older friends. So, you know, my mom was like, huh? You need her number? I said, yeah, Ma, I need to call her and check on her. And so I just give God the praise, you know, because every once in a while I miss it. I didn't miss it this time. I want to be able to be used by God when he needs me to be available. I pray that this message blesses you, but more so I pray that it gives you the faith and the unction to keep going, even though it looks like things are not the way they should be or you think they should be. Just trust God. Let him use you where you are, no matter what is going on in your life. Listen, because he's speaking. And then do what he asks you. Be blessed. God loves you, and so do I. Thank you.